Hello and welcome to Travels with Shane and Matt.
Hi.
This is Matt.
And I'm Shane.
We are in the Cotswolds. We got here last night, we're staying at a place called Beaverston Castle, and it was pitch black when we got here, so we've not had much of a look. And to be fair, I couldn't sleep last night, so I've been up since 4:45. So it's now about
half past eight.
We've already driven half an hour and we've come to Bibury. We're then going to go to Cirencester and then Tetbury, and then we're going to go back to the castle. That sounds ridiculous, I know. And chill, read, face mask, have a bath, and just go from there. So apparently thunderstorms are coming in a couple of hours, so we're going to try and get round now. Ooh, it looks nice, Matt. So we'll take you along for the journey. Here's Bibury. This is the garden of the Swan Hotel. Nice. We've just parked up at Bibury Trout Farm Park. It said it was free on the internet, however, £3 when we got there. Oh, look at the cygnet down here. Hello, little one. Hello. Matt's in his element already. It is pretty gorgeous though. So top tip, yes, we've just paid for parking, but because we're so early, there's a free one here in the village, bang slap in the middle. But you live and you learn. So if any of you come to Bibury, then get here nice and early and have a free parking, and then comment to say that you knew about it because of us. I'll be chuffed. Car parking saga continues. Look at all of this free parking. It goes on forever. But I'm owning this as my mistake. Oh, look at that cottage, Matt. Mm-hmm. Five Swan Cottage. Beautiful. Here's St. Mary the Virgin. It's only 10 to 9, so doubt it's open. Oh, blow me down. Go inside. What's this bit called?
Something, what? I can't remember.
Arlington or something. It's absolutely beautiful. We've made it to Cirencester. And we've parked a little bit out of the town because we found somewhere that was free car parking. And after my £3 loss, whew, I'm trying to claw that back. So we're now trying to find the town. Aren't we, Matt?
We are. It's just up to the left.
That's what he says. And then we're going to go to St. John the Baptist Church, have a wander around. Getting hungry already because obviously I had breakfast at the crack of dawn.
Yeah, I think it'll be an early lunch.
It will be an early lunch. And it's supposed to be thunder and lightning right now. And at the minute, we're doing well. We've gone sunglasses.
I'm not sure how long these on last.
No, umbrella will be coming out very soon.
We found Cirencester. Not sure we'll be here long, but Matt's nipped into Waterstones. And we're going to head up to a church up there. We've come a little bit further on, and this bit's a bit cuter. So we're going to go in there.
No.
Matt, did you buy any books?
I didn't buy any books, but somebody did recommend one. And
who did?
Walked out, the woman.
Oh, they always recommend something. Yeah. It's called upselling in another shop, Matt.
No, it was a customer that recommended it.
Oh, okay, I'll let her off. Just found the Portuguese tarts, and I'm chuffed. And 2 weeks today, we're actually going to be in Portugal. Ooh, tower open, Matt. Yeah, 2 weeks today we're going on a cruise, so we'll be in Lisbon and Porto having Portuguese tarts there, so I'm very excited. That was after you going to the summer fair the other week.
No,
that's it, Jaime. Oh, you've learned. Matthew will be impressed.
See you soon.
So we've just come above the bell ringing. Here we go.
Jesus, what?
Nearly made my half jump. So I've just had a little go, which I'm sure you've just seen. Matt had a little go. Now we're going to go to the top. We're just above the bells now. This is officially a busman's holiday. It's going to be loud. It's a bit harder than that. Made it to the top, and Matt just smashed his head on that. Not his brightest move. Climbed the tower, had a go on the bells, and we've been to the roof, and now we're back on down. Nice little side street. We're just starting to think we're peckish, so having a little look. We've walked past the estate and heading into the park now. This terrace house is absolutely beautiful. We're now in Tetbury. We've been into a lovely church and there was a choir rehearsing for a concert tonight. And we've just had some food in the, I think it's called Snooty Fox. And then Matt's just found this High Grove shop. So having a little look. It smells amazing. Just to put this in context, it's the 26th of August, and it's hailing. Yeah, hailing. We're back at Beverston Castle. That's our cottage up there. You've just seen the downpour, and now it's perfect sunny. And this is our church, right next to the cottage. So it says it's open 24 hours a day apparently. So we're going to have a little look. It's an old Norman church from 1200s. So this is St. Mary's.
church. There's a service here tomorrow at 10:30. These are some flowers from the walled kitchen garden, which is part of the Airbnb you can just have access to, which is nice. We're exploring old map. That's what we needed for the hedgehog. We adopted the hedgehog, he accidentally fell in the pond and died. We're just going looking for the walled garden. But this is beautiful, the moat, yeah. Oh, stunning. Can't begin to tell you how excited Matt is that he's just found this garden. And yeah, apparently we're just allowed in it. It just feels a bit naughty. Here's the walled garden. We timed it perfectly for the sun to come out. And as I say, it says on the email, help yourself to all the produce. So Matt's going to be digging up dahlia tubers. Cute as a button, isn't it?
Yeah.
Greenhouses.
They obviously like dahlias. You can't believe that half an hour ago it was hailing.
It's crazy.
I love this bit, the moat. All the fernery. Oh, yeah, yeah, this is right. Just be careful. It looks like part of the old castle.
It's 7 o'clock and we've been resting since about 2 o'clock. We've had bath, we've had face mask, we've done reading, we've just had a cottage pie for dinner, and I can't sit still for this many hours if I'm honest, so I'm now making us go for a little walk. Although we've done 15,000 steps already and been up since 5 o'clock, I can't just sit still. So we're gonna go and have a little look again, probably. See what it's like on an evening, and then do a little lap. Thanks, and do a little lap. But this is a bit of the Airbnb actually. Stairs up to the bedroom, dining area, sofa, around there is kitchen. Good morning. We are now in Ladick, and this is the village of Lacock. We're not really sure. But this bit here, imagine without any cars, is where they did the King's Procession in Downton Abbey Movie 1.
There's a nice looking pub for nature.
They also filmed Harry Potter here, some Larkford, Candleford or something like that. It's absolutely stunning. Now all these houses are now residence houses, but all owned by the National Trust. I get they need their cars, but it is a shame that they don't park in the car park. Keep the beauty. What is it?
It looks like a cat or something.
This is the house that Horace Slughorn was staying in Harry Potter and the Half-Blood Prince.
He was trying to pretend that he wasn't.
He was trying to pretend that he wasn't what?
Available to teach.
Every single corner of this village is lovely. Highly recommend coming to Lacock Lacock, Lacock. Whatever this place is called, it's spelled L-A-C-O-C-K. Get yourself here. Agree, Matt?
I would agree, it's really pretty. It's film location central.
You get a map and it tells you where they filmed everything. Oh, the bells have just stopped chiming.
The grey clouds have gone and the sun is here. Matt's already planning what we're going to have for lunch, so he's going to read the menu. We are the sort of people that are planning our next meal as we're eating this meal. So it makes a lot of sense. And that is our first sighting of Lacock Abbey. This is the first ever photo, or first picture, using negative photography, was of this window. And there you go. Here's the courtyard. Oh, that's a fig plant. I want the fig plant. Fig tree. That's the bakehouse. This is the courtyard. It's really quiet. Look at who. Gargoyles.
A bit random, aren't they?
This is St. Cyriac's Church of Lacock. And the service is finished now, so we're going to head on in.
We've just been through Castle Coombe. And I think everyone and their mother had been there, so we couldn't stop, to be fair. It was so, so busy. So we've now driven on to Dyrham Park. Matt's just getting us a ticket, and then we're going to head in. We've been here before, but it was during COVID, so you couldn't go in the house or shops or anything, really. It was just all outdoor, so fingers crossed it'll be good. Here he comes. He looks excited. Here we are. This is the house. You get a gorgeous view from up on that hill to the right. Terrible news about the herd of deer that they had. Unfortunately, they had a terrible case of bovine TB, so they've all had to be culled. So unfortunately, there's no deer in the parkland anymore. Heading up to the church.
You going this way or going up there?
There it is.
It's 20 to 8 on Sunday night, and we've come for a little drive to Tetbury for the evening. Well, just have a little wander, because I can't work out whether to sit or stand for my back, so I'm doing everything I can to try and keep moving. Here we are at Chipping Steps, just off from Chipping Car Park. I bet earlier today it was really busy, but at 8 o'clock at night, it's lovely and quiet. These houses are absolutely gorgeous, aren't they?
Yeah.
We've just come back into the church, which is next to the Airbnb. It's about 8 o'clock at night, but it's just open, as I said earlier, 24 hours a day. Which seems a bit weird, feels a bit naughty. Mary?
Thanks for watching. We hope you enjoyed. Now click like and subscribe, and we'll see you next time.